Today, we looked at HARS Aviation Museum in Albion Park. They give you a lot of information and description. And it is for free to subscribe to ELLEE'S Adventure Vlogs YouTube channel and to call the source of hotline. I need to address that to the depressed people. And I've got lots of videos coming your way, bangers of videos.
Just over 20 hours in the air, so longest flight by a commercial aircraft at the time. So in recent years, that aircraft has started to fly longer distances.
This is the one from Seattle in America. These propellers will kill you if you get sucked in. Look how huge it is in here for the wheel.
They all fold up inside there.
Yeah, sorry about that.
These wheels are amazing too. Your car might have, I don't know, 35, 40 psi pounds per square inch.
That's a lot of psi.
It's got 200. So there's about four times more pressure in them than you have in your car.
Yep, the car ones are going to kabam.
Okay, let's go up the back stairs here.
And they're the other ones. Yeah, I'm going to go inside now the airplane. Boeing 747.
747?
That's an air wing.
So here we are on the aircraft. This is last fitted out in about the year 2000. So it looks a bit old.
Yeah.
It's about 20 years old.
Yeah, it needs an upgrade.
371 seats in this aircraft for 371 passengers in economy, premium economy and business.
Where's first class?
No first class on this one. Didn't need first class. The routes it was flying.
Yeah, the other one that John Travolta drives, that's first class.
The other ones fly first class, yeah.
Yes.
About 10 people across. These are called wide-body aircrafts when they made the aircraft wider and put two aisles in it. So wide-body aircraft, by definition, you've got two aisles. That's typically what it is.
Yes.
They got more and more, and now look at that.
What about the Airbus?
10 seats.
Yeah, right, but the Airbus, that's got more than 10 seats.
Well, it's also got, it's got 10, but it's got two levels.
Yeah, two levels. Can you go up on the second level?
We can go to the second level of this one, yeah.
What about, we'll do that. What about the Airbus? Am I allowed to go on the second level?
We haven't got an Airbus here.
If I go, you know, Sydney Airport, of course.
You went to Sydney Airport, you're getting a tour, I'm sure they'd take you on the second level.
Yeah.
And when people travel on both levels. So.
Exactly.
Depending what ticket you've got.
Yeah. Cool.
Here's where the crew member in charge of all the crew in the board of the aircraft is, the person.
And they got the phone.
They got phones for talking to people, they're controlling all the everything, they're looking after all the, buying all the bits and pieces that need, checking everyone's getting fed.
Yeah.
This aircraft, during its life, carried about 4 million passengers.
Wow, a lot of people.
Flew about 85 million kilometres. That's like flying to the moon and back 100 times. So it did a lot of hard work in its life.
Yeah.
The end of its life, 2015. Yeah. Here it is, coming and touching down, landing at Albion Park Aircraft, the first 747 to ever
land. Who was driving this airplane?
Pilots, Qantas pilots brought it down.
Oh, okay. That's the cockpit. That's the cockpit, where the pilot seats.
Yeah.
They got a big screen, LCD screen.
Oh yeah, when they built this aircraft, they went from all the old mechanical things to all computer screens.
Yep, technology, new 21st century.
So complete new technology, so it's a whole new aircraft. That's why the 747-400 is such an important
aircraft. But this door will be shut.
When you're flying, absolutely.
Yes. Yeah. I'm just recording airplanes.
Yeah.
You can explain the history of
the big one over there called Connie. That's a super constellation.
Yeah.
That's our flagship, one of our very special aircraft. The engines in it are these.
What kind of engine is this?
It's made by a company called Wright. It's a radial piston-driven engine. And there are 9 pistons and another 9 pistons that are 18 pistons.
That's a lot of pistons.
That's a lot of liters too. 55 liters capacity.
That's a lot of liters.
That's a lot of liters. So this is a cut-down version of the engine.
This is a cut-down version of the engine.
So bits and pieces pulled off so we can see what it looks like inside.
Yeah.
And we got 4 of those on the Constellation. And on our Neptune aircraft, we got 4 as well. Big, powerful engines. How many horsepower? Let's work out a look. 3,000 horsepower. How about
that? That's got balls.
That will definitely move. Well, it does. It's got to pull these big aircraft through the air. Well, we got one aircraft, the Sabre sells in 30mm cannon, so inch size. So
damn!
Cannon that be.
Shush. I'm just going to the other side. Because I want to record the other side of it.
Okay. Well, let's come around here. We'll have a look at this one. So this is a two-engine jet
fire.
Military aircraft. Come around here.
Yeah, we'll go have a tour in there.
Yeah. As we...
That's... A small one of it, the version.
As we walk around inside, just be careful, everyone. As you walk around, don't hit your head on something. Don't kick something with your feet. So just be very careful.
I'm wide awake today.
Some of these bits are pretty sharp.
What kind of plane is this airplane?
This one. Which one?
This one here.
This one here? This is known as a Sea Venom. It's one of the very early jet aircraft.
For the Army?
Navy. The Navy.
Navy, sick. One. Look how big it is. Here's the other one. I'm going to show you guys now. Outside. Oh, there's the oil. Damn. Oil leak of here. I'm coming. Southern Presentation. Big airplane. Big jets. Oh, yeah. Yes, and the Army one?
Yep, the Army is a big, it's a transportation aircraft.
Yes. I can't go because that's a, I can't.
We're going to see another one when we go to the other hangar. We'll get up closer to another one.
Yeah.
Let's have a look inside. This one. The last one in the world,
that's a cockpit.
That's unbolted for me. Yeah. Might have been originally here. Look at the size of the bolts on it.
Yeah.
It was bolted on.
Yeah.
21 degrees. Nice warm day. Lovely day.
It is.
It's a hot day, you know. Really hot, stinking hot in here.
Yep.
So it's not, thank goodness. Okay.
Look how big this engine is.
Yeah, if you have a look, you can see we've got two rows of pistons again.
Yes.
Around the like a circle. There's one in the front and one at the back. Make them big, powerful engines.
Yes. What airplane is this?
Which one over here? Let's have a look.
The green one.
The green one? Yeah. That's an Australian designed aircraft called the Wirraway.
Yeah.
A training aircraft.
Oh, for the Army.
That one's being rebuilt for training Air Force pilots.
Yeah.
So World War II vintage, Australian.
That's old.
They're old. Yeah, a lot of aircraft here are old. We can go through.
There's going to be a part two to this for the next section, my viewers. I'll see it in the part two.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It is Vince Box here. Don't forget to subscribe or bell. Thumbs up button. Leave a comment down below all. And I'm here for you depressed people. Be do say positive, live a little. Anyhow, Rick Mayfield will say, peace out and call the cornstalk. See you in the next video. In part two of this video.